Hello and welcome to fDi in the Sky, our regular video series looking at the latest stories in foreign investment. I'm Seth O'Farrell, fDi's global investment reporter.
And I'm Alex Owen Hunt, fDi's global markets editor. And today we'll be discussing a story that Seth recently wrote about Gabon in West Africa. Seth, can you tell us a little bit more about it?
Certainly. So Gabon is a country whose landmass is almost 90% covered in rainforests. And last year, it was compensated by the Central African Forest Initiative roughly $150 million to protect its rainforests.
That's really positive, and I can imagine there might be some challenges associated with that.
Certainly. Well, I think firstly, we just look at what that really means. That means that Gabon is the first country to have done this, first African country to have done this, and there are parallel moves to move into carbon, international carbon trading. That's to say that the government has issued a piece of legislation in September to lay the foundation for selling carbon credits internationally. And as I said, it's a carbon absorber because of its rainforests, and it absorbs roughly 100 million tons of carbon annually.
Wow, that's a massive amount of carbon. And clearly this is going to bring extra revenue into Gabon. But I can imagine there's a conflict between the preservation of their rainforest and some of their economic development goals. Can you speak a bit to that conflict?
Absolutely. So, of course, it's all great that this money might be flowing into Gabon as a result of their rainforest, and that it is a sort of green player in a kind of carbon pricing sense. But of course, in another sense, it still has a long way to go in terms of infrastructure, and definitely in terms of green infrastructure. So yes, of course, carbon pricing creates very few jobs, whereas sustainable logging or investments into hydropower or solar power, that creates jobs. So I think, yes, the Minister of Energy told me that it's not viable to pay people hundreds of millions of dollars to watch trees grow. Instead, capital investments need to flow into specific industries in Gabon that need shoring up and need developing.
Well, clearly it's an interesting example of the challenges posed by the energy transition. If you want to read Seth's full story, please go to fdiintelligence.com, and we'll be back soon with another video to discuss the latest trends in foreign investment.